Every video I create, I believe in helping you create new technology that can be innovative and creative. The way I create my videos is by making a wide variety of basic IT videos that are easy to understand and will create a base for your future IT creations. My tutorials are about IoT devices, design, databases, websites, apps, and so much more. Hello world, my name is Asali, meaning basic in the language Hausa. Today we will be learning how to control an LED with an Arduino Uno. Explanation of an Arduino program. So before we get coding all over the place, I will firstly explain some basic things that you will want to know if you're somewhat new to writing code. Global variables. At the top, all possible variables that we need in our program are first declared to preserve our values. We have different types of variables. The type boolean, true or false, the type int, integers, the type float, decimal numbers. When you declare a variable, you can assign a value to it at once and immediately. This is called initialization. Functions. Functions are blocks of code that you can call elsewhere in your code. In the example, you see two instances, setup and loop. An Arduino program must always contain these two functions, always. Note that all statements within a function are between two brackets. These brackets indicate the start, this one, and the end of the function, this one. After the name of the function, you need two parentheses, over here. So this is the name. Those two parentheses can contain name and type of any parameters or arguments, variables that have to be given to the function for when it's called. The functions setup and loop are done behind the scenes by the Arduino library itself, so we can't give parameters to that. If you add some of your own functions, this may be possible. Executing. So when you execute your program, the setup function is called once. For example, it is going to be used to initialize pins or to configure serial communication. So we write as a comment. And then after the setup function is finished, the loop function is executed. That function becomes, as her name says, in a loop, or in this case, infinite. The loop function is continuously called again. In this function, we may play some code that checks whether we press a button or a sensor that reads out data. So we write right above the loop. Now let's start with making the LED blink on pin number 13. First, write a little comment on what's going to happen above our code. Alright, now we write int LED equals 13 semicolon, meaning that with this rule we make a variable of the type int, integers, with the name LED, and we assign the value 13 to it. Note that each statement must be closed with a semicolon. So I add an extra comment. You can of course also declare this variable in the code. These will only then within the block in which they are defined be initialized. So if you were to write this line in the setup function over here, the variable won't keep track of the value in the entire program. This is called a local variable. However, when you write it over here, this variable can be used elsewhere in the entire program. The one you and I just created is called a global variable because it's available everywhere in the code and not locally. Now we will write in our setup function pin mode LED output and a semicolon. So pin mode allows you to configure the specified pin to behave either as an input or as an output. Input meaning incoming data from like a sensor or a press of a button. But in our case, we have to turn on a LED, so this has to be output because we are sending something out. So we write configuration of the pin output or input. Take note that you can also write 13 instead of LED and just delete the integer LED. But I advise you to not do this and always create a global variable, but you can run this and it will still work. But for now, we won't do this. Now, you want to write digital write in our void loop. Digital write, LED, high. Digital write allows you to write a high or a low value to a digital pin. So high meaning high voltage, so the LED will turn on. Low meaning a low voltage, so the LED won't turn on. So I add a little comment saying, turn the LED on, high is the voltage level. Then we write delay 1000. This one's pretty obvious. Delay pauses the program for the amount of time in milliseconds. So 1000 milliseconds meaning 1 second. And we add a little comment saying, wait for a second. And now we're going to turn the LED back off. So this time the digital write has to be low to turn off the LED. And another delay to make it even. So in the program above, we are letting an LED flash. The LED is always 1 second on and off. Now let's try and run the code. Executing the program. The program is checked via the check button, the check mark at the top left. So click on this and we'll see if there are any errors in our code or not. Okay, no errors now. Via the upload button, the arrow to the right, we can upload the program to the flash memory from the microcontroller. During the upload, you will see the communication LEDs TX and RX flashing on the Arduino board. If everything went well, you will now see an orange LED next to the pin 13 flashing alternately. Also, if you were to remove the USB cable, the program keeps running. Well, the board must have an external power supply, of course. In the next video, we will see how to make an actual LED blink with the use of a button. You'll also see two different ways to do this, one with almost no code and one with a lot more code. Both of these have their own advantages and disadvantages. And after this, you'll get an extra task to complete on your own. All of that will be in the next video, so watch till the end of this video and you'll be directed to the next video. Also, you can go to my Patreon page and there you will find all the code from today's video, as all the code from all of my other videos. So the link for that is in the description down below. What to do now? Go to Amazon and buy yourself the original Arduino Uno starter kit, or the cheaper version. Link for that will be in the description. There should be an affiliate link and a normal link. The affiliate link meaning I will get a small percentage of the price that you're paying for referring you to the product. This doesn't mean the price is higher for you, so don't worry. But if you want to support me, definitely go and use that link to buy the Arduino Uno and or starter kit. So that's it for today, guys. Don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss out on the next video. And I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye, world.